So I just wanted to take a minute and sort of give you an idea of what a child or a teen coming to the day might encounter. We've developed something that's a little bit different than what people might expect, and I thought it might be interesting to sort of give you a little demo. So please keep in mind that this is all in beta. We are still developing and working on the program, so some of these things are not exactly as they will be on the day of the event, but you will hopefully get the idea of what we are trying to do. So each child or participant coming to Eagle's Claw will get a one of these schedules. And we're hoping that this is something that helps them just stay oriented. They can always come back here if they don't know where they're supposed to be next. It'll give them some sort of an idea of how to move around if they don't want to just go exploring. So first of all, we've created this world here at World Anvil. And this here is sort of an introductory page that has links to important information and things that the kids might explore on their day at Eagle's Claw. This will also be used for our week-long adventures, the week-long camp program, and also for the week-to-week programs that we are starting after this, the conclusion of the 16th of the April 16th event. So we will also be using this for the week-long event for April Vacation Week, and we will also they can refer back to this during their week-to-week Dungeons and Dragons tables. So this is just a really good kind of a launching pad for kids, and they can explore and kind of get more information about the world. So we're going to start here with the player handbook. And here is, it doesn't really have too much here yet. We're still filling this part out, but they can read the basic article on what Eagle's Claw is here. And go to, let's see, player handbook. Oops, oh, right here. Okay, so they can access the full welcome book by clicking here. And the welcome book is set up to give some basic information. A lot of this will also be in the wiki, but this is a very kind of handy place where they can explore and find more information about the background of the school, the background of the different founders of the school, sort of our moral values and the reasons why that people come to Eagle's Claw, and a lot more about the lore. They also have a link here for their sorting quiz, which will take them through a number of questions that they can answer to find out which house that they should be sorted into. So that is that section of the wiki. Let's see, what else can I show you? The other parts here that may be useful. The World Atlas we're still building. There's a little bit of information here on the world and different things that that are happening. There is a main map here, and I'll just give you an idea. We have a color version of this that will be replaced, but this is sort of the map, and it shows just information about the different places around the Eagle's Claw School. Now, Eagle's Claw is a magical school, but it is not tucked far, far away from all of human eyes. It is actually in the middle of the great city of New Bedford. So if you click here, this will tell people a little bit more about the old church in which that it is. Here's all the different landmarks and more information about the different houses and locations that are there. And then they can also enter the building here. And so this is an interactive map. This is not going to be our final one, but you can at least get the idea of what they can do. The Great Hall here is a place where They might go for announcements or other things happening. You'll also see this linked here, the Great Hall. And we are using Discord to help people sort of get oriented and be able to speak to one another, whether it's in chat, a moderated chat, or in audio. Oop, hello, bye-bye. but this will give you sort of an idea of how we are using this technology as a back end to allow people to talk to each other or to watch a scene that will be happening and also to sort of hang out in their common rooms and chat. So once they are here in the castle, they can go explore different areas. They can find out maybe some secrets or some things that that might be happening. They can go to classes, like this is the dance room. This is, I think one of these is Futhark the Elder, his ancient runes class. And we'll dig into that in a little bit as well. But they'll also use this to go, up and down between the levels of Eagle's Claw, and just kind of stay oriented. There's a similar mechanic outside the castle where they can go to different locations there as well. And this is if they were heading out to, I have on the schedule that they've got charms with Professor Kraftwick, so they could actually go directly to the classroom here using the link for the Google Classroom, or they could actually go exploring and find themselves there as well. So here are a little loud. We're working on that. So you'll see that there's a little bit of sounds going on. We're going to turn those down so they're not quite so loud. But here is the magical crafting and charms class that they will be able to join and see. We have not filled this out yet, but you'll be able to see that they've got they can do classwork in these and have conversations as they take their class. And we'll have another live stream with the professors next week. So that should give you sort of an idea. What else can I show you? They will have either two classes in the morning with a break in between, or they'll have two classes in the afternoon. We are doing that so that the Dungeons and Dragons game, which is their exploration phase, it has enough time to complete. So I've just put in for now, I've put in here that they're going to go investigate the greenhouse with the groundskeeper. So they'd be linked directly to whichever program it is that they are, where they're going to have their Dungeons and Dragons game. And you'll see this is a Roll20. This is another software that we use. It's not what I expected to see. Let's see. Oh, there we go. Just took a second to load. So here, these are interactive maps where the students can zoom in or zoom out. They'll be able to move their, this is one of the tokens. They can move their piece around the board when they need to. They can also roll their dice using this app. So you'll see that just popped up over here. And I rolled a 17. So that's not too shabby. So that is everything that I have to show you right now. As we continue to develop this, we will show you even more and get some time with both the professors that you guys can watch, and we'll also have time with the Dungeon Masters, and you'll meet them and get to hear a little bit more about the lore and the adventures that they have planned. We can't wait to see you there.